Good morning, dear colleagues. I know that we're short of time, so we'll try to be brief. You've heard the topic of my presentation. In Russia, every year, around 11,000 patients need surgery for this reason. These are difficult surgeries and are accompanied by many complications and high level of mortality. European Society for Enhanced Recovery, ERAS, has published very good publication some time ago, their guidelines. That's the protocol. Overall, their guidelines have 45 provisions, and that's the protocol that we started using even before it was published. I will try to tell you in brief. That's the protocol for accelerated healing. On an outpatient stage, the patient is being examined by the outpatient doctor, surgeon, and anesthesiologist. It is worthwhile to recommend to stop smoking, though the positive effect from stopping smoking is 4 weeks after stopping, and not all the patients stop smoking. The patients are hospitalized in advance of their operation, a day before their operation. The surgeon has to see the patient once again, go through the lab tests, and if need be, change the operation tactics. If the patient is administered on the day of the operation, this is not always possible. The patient is not, the food intake is not limited on the day prior. Last drink intake 2 hours before the surgery. The patient has to be warmed up and early extubation, that's for the anesthesiology. Now, surgery. A lot has been said today about the access to the chest. In the same publication of EBAR, it is said that number of ports does not impact the result. 2-3 weeks after the operation, nobody will remember how many ports there were. The safety during the procedure, during the intervention, is much more important. Each surgeon has to define what is more convenient, what is better for thoracoscopy, in his opinion. If there is no possibility to perform thoracoscopy, you don't have any reason to still try and perform the access. Because if the patient comes to you a year afterwards with a recurrence, it wouldn't matter much which technique was used. Only one drainage is installed into the pleural cavity, and the vacuum has to be minimal. If there are no specific risk factors like emphysema, passive drainage of the pleural cavity may be used, and it has to be removed at an early stage. French Society of Cardiothoracic Surgeons had a meeting a week ago. I communicated with many colleagues, and I must say that many French sites remove drainage 1 day after installation if there is no air leaks, and no drainage methods are being also used. And certainly, if there's no collapse of the lungs. Post-op period is quite clear. The patients have to be mobilized on the day of the operation. They resume food intake and may be discharged on the same day, the day of the operation. They may be discharged if less than 3 on VAC scale. and all the rest is okay. We started this work back in 2014 in Moscow in two different clinics. Selection of patients was quite strict. You see only those patients included here for whom we could perform thoracoscopic resections without conversions. 137 patients in all. Sublobar lung resections, most of them in connection with metastasis, and almost one-fourth were primary lung cancer or intolerability of the functional anatomical lobe resection, or when there were advanced lung cancers, and in case of early lung cancer, lymphodissection is always performed. Time of operation 53 minutes on average, blood loss less than 50 ml, number of complications was not large, around 6%, 9 patients, and the severity was not high, mainly antibacterial therapy due to inflammatory infiltration of the parenchyma. No drainage management of patients. 33 patients after sublobar resections didn't have any pleural drainage at the end of the operation under the endoscopically guided. We pumped out all the air and then sutured the pleural cavity. We perform X-ray on the day, on the same day, in order to confirm the good results. There were complications, 6%, not that much, but two patients needed to drainage installation. In post-op stay in hospital was 2 days. Vasculectomies, 79 patients, time of operation 3 hours, the blood loss around 100 ml. Post-op days in hospital, on average 5. Complications almost in 20% of cases, including several severe patients who spent a long time in ICU, but not many of patients. Overall, for the two groups, all complications happened in 10% of cases. Most often these were inflammatory changes in the lungs. Antibiotics were prescribed, or violation of rhythm. Also, medications were prescribed. Thoracoscopies were performed in case of anastasis, long-term anastasis, or impossibility of debridement of pleural cavity. 4A, severe pneumonias that needed ICU stay, and in one case there was a multi-organ failure, and mechanical ventilation of the lungs had to be prolonged. Re-operations, re-interventions, 6 patients in 2 groups. The patients come back either with pneumonia or they accumulated exudate, and thus the drainage of pleural cavity was needed. All of them were discharged in satisfactory condition. That's our series. We have learned this technique from our British colleagues. You know that 1, 2, 3 ports doesn't matter the number. You may use the intercostal space for one of the ports, and when we have to remove the lobe by the intercostal space, first of all, it impacts the nerves and may lead to pain syndrome later. 4 to 5 centimeters incision is made upon neurosis. The anterior mediastinum is where we form the channel. No rigid anatomical structures there, and we can remove practically any tissue or any structure from this incision. For us, we use subxiphoidal access for the removal of the lobe. In conclusion, the use of this accelerated protocol is possible in practice. It is convenient, doesn't demand a lot of costs, and may bring down the average stay of patients in the hospital and achieve good results, and also decrease the number of complications. Thank you. Questions? Once again, out of the mic. Six people. Can we have my slides back? 6% came back in after 7 to 10 days. Not that much. We know that some patients come back. If the patients do not come back, this is probably not the trend, because the complications exist always, and these patients have to treat. If they do not come back to the site where the surgery was performed, they treat these complications in an outpatient department, which is not usually best. Any patient when they are discharged, we always write that if there is any worsening of condition, please call, and we provide our contact telephone numbers. We always take patients, and we resolve these complications based on the obligatory medical insurance. No possibility to interpret when the people are not using mics. The goal is very simple. We have to achieve better results for the patients. Our goal, all of us have the same goal, and it is a generous goal. We are not crazy. We understand that these are patients who have subpleural tumors. These are patients without emphysema. These are patients with maximum two suturing devices and no leaks with bubble test, no collapse of the lung. These are controlled patients. We do not discharge them the same day. We didn't have tense pneumothoraxes. We had some pneumothoraxes. Redrainage is not frightening. Urinary catheter is installed during anatomical lung resection. Usually 2 hours is the duration of the surgery, and it is removed while the patient is still under the narcosis. Central veins always as well in anatomical resections. Anesthesiologists are very cautious in terms of thoracic surgeries. There is a risk of damaging main vessels. This is standard prevention. Cephalosporin second generation, we do not use antibiotics in standard operations. No, no, not at all. Okay, more. pre-op preparation, first hospitalize the day before, shower the day before, and in the morning on the day of operation, no mechanical preparation of the bowels. In the morning from 6 to 7 a.m., the patient drinks one glass clear fluid, and that's it. And antibiotic and thromba prevention in accordance with guidelines. We always have questions when we have something new. VAS and RAS are not that new. A new trend is fast track, so we have some questions until the mentality is adapted. Our mentality is always works always like this. First we say, "Ah, nonsense." Then we start looking at the details. Now we're in the first stage, perceiving this as nonsense, but the trends force us to move forward and to take all the very best from what is being on offer. Any questions more? No.